right, today we're going to talk about classifications of numbers. So all numbers, whether they exist on a number line or not. Okay. So all numbers, if you take all numbers that exist, that's the world of complex numbers. Okay, some examples. 2 minus 3i, square root of 3, negative 5i. 27.5, square root of negative 3. Notice, some of these are imaginary. The I means a square root of negative 1. These are imaginary numbers. These are real numbers. Okay? If you don't know what imaginary numbers are, don't worry about it. We're going to talk about this a lot later in the year. Okay, but complex numbers include real numbers. And these are numbers that have points on the number line. Okay, examples. 3, 1.5, pi, negative 4/3. Okay, you draw out a number line. You could point to where all of these numbers would fall on the number line. Okay. It's not real. It's an imaginary number. Imaginary numbers. Okay? Things like square root of negative 3. 5 times the square root of negative 2. Okay? These are basically square roots of negatives. And there are no points on the number line. And we're going to focus on this side today. So really, that we're done with this side for now. This we're going to break down into all the different classifications of numbers. You can abbreviate real numbers, and you might have seen this before. Capital R. A lot of times they put two little sticks here, so it looks different than a regular capital R. Okay, that's an abbreviation for real numbers. Now, under real numbers, we're going to break this down into rational numbers and irrational numbers. Okay. Rational numbers are numbers that can be written as the ratio of two integers. Any number that can be written as the ratio of two integers. Example, something like 4/5. 7.31. Even though that's a decimal, you could put that over 1. You could multiply by 100. Multiply by 100 and get 731 over 100. That's a ratio of integers. Negative 5. Square root of 9, which simplifies to 3. So even though it looks like a radical, it's still a rational number because it simplifies to something that can be written as a ratio of integers. Irrational numbers cannot be written as the ratio of integers. So irrational numbers cannot be written as ratio of integers, something like the square root of 5. Okay? If you were to take the square root of 5, plug that in your calculator, you get a decimal that never ended. Never repeat it. Negative 2 rad 10. Irrational numbers can be positive or negative. They also numbers like pi. Probably know 3.14159 dot 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 dot. Never ends, never repeats. E. It's another number, kind of like pi. Never ends, never repeats. When written as the decimal. Okay, these two numbers are radicals. These two numbers are called transcendental numbers. Transcendental numbers. They're these magical, beautiful numbers that are found in nature. It's not like someone decided, oh, let's make pi about 3.14. Something that was discovered. So in a way, they transcend that. They transcend all other numbers. Right? So that's kind of a way I like to think about those. Okay. Now, an abbreviation for rational numbers is a cube. And you can think about a quotient is a ratio of two integers. Irrational numbers, we're just going to use I. I is what you would use to abbreviate irrational numbers. Right? Notice I is not used for imaginary numbers. I is used for irrational numbers. Okay. Now, under the rational numbers, we break down further into integers. Integers are a subset of the rational numbers. Now, integers are just whole numbers and their opposites. Okay. Whole numbers are like 0, 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. And their opposite. Opposite of numbers, you make it negative. Opposite of 0 is negative 0, still 0. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, dot, dot, dot. These will go on forever in both directions. Okay, so here's your integers. We're going to use to abbreviate integers. It's a capital Z. It comes from a German word, Zahlen or Zahlen, something like that. Zahl or Zahlen. That was a little bit harder to remember that Z represents integers. Notice we can't use I again because we already used I up here. Okay. These numbers here, 0 and above, we call these whole numbers. Whole numbers are a subset of the set of integers, so that's going to be our next category. Whole numbers. Okay. So they are the 0 and above, the integers 0 and above. I don't think we have to write that. We could just write. All numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, dot, 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 and go all the way to positive infinity. Just the integers 0 and above. Whole numbers, to abbreviate whole numbers, we're going to use W. Okay? And then subset of whole numbers are the counting numbers or natural numbers. Two words that mean the same thing. The counting numbers are the natural numbers. Counting numbers is a little more intuitive. You start counting things. Count 1, 2, 3. You start with 1. You don't start with 0. So counting numbers are the positive integers. Notice counting and natural numbers are very similar to whole numbers. Whole numbers include 0. Counting numbers don't. And this we're going to use an N for counting numbers. Natural numbers. Okay. Subset of counting or natural numbers is just the digits. And digits are just the integers 0 through 9. 0, 1, 2, 3, dot, 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 all the way to 9. Another way to think of digits, it's like the numbers on your telephone, 0 through 9. That's all we're going to talk about with the classifications of numbers.